Hello everyone and welcome to Daily Newspaper Analysis, which is brought to you by Lawseco. So let's see the newspaper articles for 24th September 2021. So we have two articles today. The first is from The Hindu, which is titled as Vital Relief for the COVID Deceased. This basically talks about a new package that has been launched by the government. What is it about and how will it actually relieve the COVID deceased and their families basically has been discussed in this article. The second one is from the Indian Express, which is titled as What New WHO Pollution Norms Mean for India. So this article talks about the new WHO pollution norms for the air pollution and how much is India able to move on these directions or on these lines of action has been discussed in this article. This newspaper analysis is presented by me. My name is Sheva Khan. I am a law graduate and I have completed my law degree from Uttaranchal University. I also was the gold batch gold medalist, and I also have been a national debater and a public speaker. Here at Lawseco, I'm working as the manager for current affairs vertical and also as the current affairs expert. If you wish to connect with me, you can find me on my Twitter and LinkedIn handles. Both are in the description box below. Let's see what is the multiple choice question from previous discussions. Prakash Singh versus Union of India case deals with. Your options are prison reforms, police reforms, both A and B, or none of the above. This is the descriptive question from the previous discussion itself. Critically analyze the process of selection of the Supreme Court and High Court judges in India. So let's start our discussion for the first article of today, which talks about the vital relief for the COVID deceased. So the Supreme Court recently ruled that the center will pay 50,000 rupees per deceased individual who would have died due to COVID within 30 days of submitting all the relevant documents. Also, no other disease in recent times has taken away the lives of tens of thousands in 18 months. So that is why keeping the gravity in mind and as to how many people have actually died because of the COVID-19, the central government, now please remember, it will be the central government that would pay an amount of 50,000 rupees to the individual as the family of the deceased individual. So if we talk about the present situation, this amount shall be a succor to families who have lost breadwinners. Like for example, there was a particular person, maybe the father, the mother, or any one person who was sole breadwinner of the family. The person used to earn for the family, and depending on that entire money, the whole family used to survive. Now, if in this case, they lose their lives, so definitely it will become very difficult for the families to sustain themselves in the coming times. And that is why this will work as a great support, specifically a great financial support to these families. Approximately 4,045,768 deaths have been recorded in India by WHO as of 13th September due to COVID-19. And this will require the center to create a fund of rupees 2,300 crores. So for that, if at all, we have to compensate the families of all these people or all these deceased. So we have to have a fund in hand of 2,300 crores. The relief amount is to be paid to the State Disaster Response Fund by the National Disaster Management Authority. Then the state authorities will create a people-friendly mechanism for the claims so that they can actually claim for this money, with fresh audits being compulsory due to indisputable undercounting in the two phases. Now let's understand that what would be the after effect or the aftermath once this decision has been taken. Firstly, it puts the issue of compensation at ease. So obviously, because when we have the compensation, the victim compensation that we have, so here the compensation or the compensating the families of these deceased people will definitely become easier. Secondly, the challenging part will be where the death certificates have not been divulged, death due to COVID-19 for undercounting purposes. Now, many a times what has happened is that due to similarity of the symptoms, some people who might have died of COVID-19, but in their death certificate, some other cause of death might have been mentioned due to the undercounting of the purposes, like basically due to no proper diagnosis or stuff like that. Now, in these situations, it would become very difficult for the families to claim this particular amount as a compensation. Let's say, for example, if a person died simply at home, so definitely it will not be easy for the hospitals to ascertain while issuing his death certificate that he actually in reality died of COVID-19, even though he might have really died of it. So in such situations, claims would become rather very difficult. Thirdly, the center must also consider providing additional compensation. So definitely it might in the situations where, you know, maybe more people of a single family might have died or, you know, a family might be more subject to such survival issues. So maybe it must also consider providing additional compensation other than just 50,000 rupees. Fourthly, the people who took their own life due to the agony of the pandemic have also been included. Now, here, this one thing is very, very, debatable over here, that people who committed suicide. There was, if you remember, there was a very famous case of an IFS or IPS officer who actually committed suicide in his own car because he thought that he might be COVID positive. So all these people who took their own lives due to the agony of the pandemic or even due to the such a stress that the pandemic caused. So that also, such people will also be included in this. Now, the question is that how do we ascertain that the actual cause of death, as in, of such agony or such stress was COVID-19. So this again becomes a very subjective issue. And lastly, the center should also set up risk insurances with the help of the states, as was suggested by the 15th Finance Commission. So this basically would be like in case, just like we have the LICs and other risk insurances. So these should also be brought up with the help of the states. With this, let's discuss the second article for the day, which talks about what new WHO, that is the World Health Organization pollution norms, mean for India. So the WHO released new air quality norms on Wednesday. The norms make India worse than it already is. So what happens is, let's see, that the loss of lives as estimated surpasses known numbers and thus active efforts have to be made. Let's understand that what are the quick fixes that we have to take care of. India shows no signs of drastic improvement in quality of air. And thousands of people die annually on an yearly basis just because of the poor quality of air. So even though we have concerned efforts in this direction, but no significant growth or no significant betterment can be seen in this direction. So enforcing better emission norms harm the short-term goals of keeping industries competitive. Now, obviously, when we talk about the SDGs, that are the Sustainable Development Goals as well, so we can see that in Sustainable Development Goal 13, we have the climate action. But under 9, we also have industry, innovation and infrastructure. Now, in this situation, there comes a problem of balance. That if at one place, we want the industries to grow, then definitely more pollution would be caused. But this would again hamper the covering up of the SDG number 13, which was for climate action. So this actually, now these are the problems which come every now and then, that if at all we want to become better in the emission norms, then it becomes difficult to keep our industries very competitive. And that is why it is necessary that we strike the right balance. We make use of the right fuels. We make use of the renewable sources of energy so that none of these goals have to be hampered at the cost of the other one. So basically the question here is that what India can capitalize on, actually what can we earn from, what can be our good source of economy and income. So the projects launched by the government like Smart City Mission, Namami Gange, Swachh Bharat, Ujwala scheme, which actually we know that it provides LPG to every household, needs to be superheaded and implemented, because all of these talk about implementation and betterment of the environment. Now, like Namami Gange, it aims at clean water in the Ganga. Then we have Swachh Bharat is overall sanitation. Ujwala is for cleaner air as well. And Smart City is about making use of more renewable sources of energy, like we have the solar energy, the wind energy, etc., for maybe, lighting the cities, for lighting the roads, etc. So all of these things need to be implemented with more rigor in hand. So let's understand that what are the low hanging fruits, basically, or what are the things that we can pick at the, at the earliest or with the ease. So India's National Clean Air Program acknowledges that all of this is a time-consuming process and it will actually take years. However, there are some immediate benefits definitely, which we're talking about as the low-hanging fruits. Like just like when there is a tree that is all bearing fruits, so the fruits that are low-hanging, that are at the downward side of the tree, they're easier to be picked. So similarly, there are some immediate benefits that can definitely be reaped from the following. Firstly, properly covering and segregating the construction sites so that, the ashes, the cement and everything, they do not just run out here and there and they, add up to the environment and specifically to the air to cause pollution. Secondly, the corners of the roads need to be properly paved. Now, in this situation, what happens is that the roads actually, because they're broken or something, a lot of dust particles, very, very minute dust particles that cannot even be seen by the naked eyes, they also enter the air and that ultimately enters our breathing channel and breathing system as well. So that also should be covered and properly paved. Then at last, the sidewalks and road dividers add to a lot of dust pollution. Now, this actually again is almost a similar thing, but the dividers, the sidewalks, so they should be made greener. The you know, the soil or the kind of content that is there, it should be held in with more intactness. So the local authorities also need to step up and achieve this target for significant improvement within a short span of time. And definitely, if we all also, as responsible individuals and citizens, come forward, then definitely we can do our bit and invest into a better and cleaner environment in the coming times. So this was all for the day. We hope you like this session. Thank you so much for joining in, and do not miss to check out the podcast for this analysis on Spotify, Google, Anchor, as well as Apple Podcast. Also, if you wish to download the PDF of today's slides, you can join our Telegram channel. The link is in the description box below, or you can scan the QR code that you can see over here. Also, for other crisp and exam-oriented content, do not forget to follow us on our Instagram channels for LawSeco Judiciary, CLAT Prep, UGC Net, and also to our latest edition, that is LawSeco Law Finance Exams. So definitely do follow these channels. Thank you so much.